Okay, saya tak ada slide lah untuk share. Cuma kita ada dihebohkan di grup kan pasal gempa bumi yang berlaku di baru saja. Saya terus buka sesuai data tengok apa yang berlaku sebenarnya. Di kawasan Philippines, close to Philippines, yang dia lihat data tu, ia adalah berpunca daripada subduction zone. Saya rasa term-term yang mungkin popular. Tapi di sana memang aktif. Philippines memang aktif dari segi gempa bumi dan we are really affected from it because we are really close to Philippines. Same to Peninsula, that really close to Indonesia lah, Sumatra. So we have a 6.7 magnitude. And when we check the historical data, the data that we collected, that area has a history of 7 to 7.9 magnitude. So this is not common to them. This is common to them. So 6.6 is still small. And because of, if we can see the distance from the Philippines to the closest Sabah island or Sabah lands, it is approximate around 458 kilometers. Saya tak tahu yang di situ ada gegaran, tapi saya rasa ada data yang kami terima is KK, Ranau, and then
Lawan.
It's a long distance. Bila kita buat analisis, biasanya kita buat up to 10 kilometers. Sebab Sabah is a very active local aspect. So, sebab kita tak rasa, anybody has felt anything?
Ada.
I think because of this building, even though it's not macam belum siap, but you can see the column here, it's very big. No? When we consider for structure designs, we recommend for increase the size of the column, so that it can sustain some loadings from the aspiration. Okay, I think we will start the briefing. Even though we don't feel any shaking, but we try to demonstrate and how to respond if there are earthquake and the building is shaking. So I think we can start for simulations. You know, we have our rules. First, you need to drop
everything.
Drop your file. And then you cover, and then you have to hold on. Okay? Hold on until the safety people or Jami can say it's safe.
You need to find a cover. Maksudnya ada meja, ada meja kecil ni kalau tidak muat tidak apa. Tapi kalau tidak ada meja, then you try to. Tapi di pintu you rasa tidak selamat, so you try to find. Yang paling penting, you have to cover the head.
Why is that?
Kenapa?
Why?
Kenapa? Kenapa? Ambil dia gula-gula.
And then we have some things hanging above our head because it's not. I think we don't know how safe is the things that above our head. So that's why you have to find a safety cover. For example, you have a chair and then you have a table. So you have to go down to the table or chair to cover from the falling objects.
At least get that on TV.
Or you can go behind the wall to avoid this okay, so I think we can do it. What is that?
Tapi kan, rupa bumi tidak ada bunyi.
Tak apa, kita test
ini saja. Sebab Tapi tsunami ya Tuhan. Gempa bumi tidak boleh lari. Bila dia kosongkan bangunan, we actually not allow that. Okay, please don't do that.
Okay, my question to all.
Lari, tapi gempa dalam first wave, we don't lari. Okay, we try to stay outside. Tapi bila dia sudah dekat sikit, you rasa, okay, 5 minit saya boleh lari. Kalau rasa 5 minit tidak boleh lari, nah, you suruh lari. Okay. Tapi sebaiknya jangan lari during the first wave. Jadi maksudnya kalau kamu duduk di belasan sabar tu, janganlah tu cepat-cepat time dulu.
Boleh jadi sekarang, doktor.
Apa tu?
No. Okay. When you start in the lift. Okay. In the lift, if you are inside the lift, when the earthquake happens, so you have to push all the button. So when the lift open, you can go outside directly as soon as possible.
Push all the button.
Yeah. At least boleh keluar. And then you go. Yeah. Tekan saja. And then go to the tangga lah, staircase. Okay.
Jangan pakai lift. Kalau dia jumpa dia compound lagi tu bad, habislah kau.
Ya, jangan.
Okay, ada satu soalan. Okay, sekiranya kita dalam bilik ini kan, kita tak sure adakah itu gempa atau bunyi apa. How do we know is it gempa as indication in the room?
So, gempa biasanya
shaking.
Dan sebenarnya kalau ada orang yang salahkan, itu shaking. So, do we look at the sign on the
wall? Yeah. Because the shaking will involve whole the building with shaking.
Doktor, ada soalan.
Yeah.
Kalau macam kembang bumi, orang itu gangguan kembang bumi itu orang itu di dalam lift itu bagaimana?
Ya, yeah, batu tekan semua batu. Tekan semua batu.
Los apa tu dia punya tu sudah.
So you have to berdoa
lah. Tapi kami selamat kau lah.
Okay, ready, ready. Tak ada bunyi. Siapa boleh buat bunyi 3, 2, 1 dekat sini? Tut, tut, tut. YouTube.
Patah
mana?
Kalau dia goyang, rasa pening jugalah. Kalau saya kalau duduk macam pening. Ada satu lagi, saya kan sebab kadang-kadang kita pergi kawasan gempa, kita pun tak sure bila nak gempa tu. Saya punya mata kan tengok ni. Lamp atau kipas tu kan?
Buka kat YouTube ni. Boleh buka YouTube tak? Pandai guna ni. Tapi ni tak ada sound lah. Tak ada sound. Tak ada. Apa 321? Haa, 321. Untuk nak buat drill. Untuk earthquake.
Itu for me lah.
Count je lah 321.
Okay,
so simulasi eh. Ready?
Siren. When the siren begin, and you start.
Tak apa, you pakai handphone nanti buka ni je. Ha. Ni tak, tak ini, ini boleh tem, boleh. Ini betul. Boleh. And then fit letak mic. Kejap.
Boleh juga.
Tutup kan.
Lagi kuat.
Okay, tak biar kuat dia. Okay, ready. Eh, kita jangan berdiri, buat macam santai lah, tengah belajar ke apa ke. Ha, buat santai.
In action.
Ha, kita tengah action ni, ada orang tengah berucap ke. Kita tak tahu, relax, relax.
Gempa bumi tidak beri kesan.
Ha. Duduk, 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 duduk. Diumumkan ketibaan yang beramat berhormat. Kira kita tengah program lah ni.
Atau puan
Tuan Puan Datin Seri. Aku pun nak duduk tu. Dia betul-betul gempa bumi ni. Hello.
Yes. So my comment, you drop, okay, cover. Tapi cover guna tangan. Tapi kamu tak tengok atas ni, ada kaca.
Ha, lainlah.
Besi mana? So you have to go under the table. Yeah, I mean, this is what people for children. Children memang dia terus pergi bawah
meja. So orang-orang ini dah injet lah. Ha, meja ni dah injet pasal ada benda jatuh kat kamu. Okay. Mana aku ni?
Okay. All right, semua boleh pergi.
Spiderman.
No, it's okay.